continue with the next presenter, Pak Iwan Aang Sunandi and Ms. Nina Sefani with the title Comparison of Some Version of Linear Factor Quantization for Vitamin and Mineral Deficiency Early Detection. So the presenter will be Pak Iwan, ya, CSA07. So please, Pak Iwan, you could share your screen.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, time around 10 minutes, you can slideshow.
Okay.
Okay, thank you, Pak. 10 minutes and then we continue with the QA. Please, Pak.
Yes, okay. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Iwan Sunandi from Faculty of Engineering and Computer Science, Kida Wacana Christian University, Jakarta. It's a pleasure to me and my team, Nina and Ricardo, to share our research with all of you. This time, I will be presenting our research with the title of the comparison of some version of linear factor quantization or LFQ for vitamin and mineral deficiency early detection. In the next slide, and this is a outline of our today presentation. We will start from the introduction and problem formulation with offered solution. Then we will explain briefly about the data set used in the experiment, followed by the methodology and the result from obtained from the experiment. Let's we start with the introduction first. In this section, I will explain about the motivation of this research and some of the previous works related with the experiment. The first point in here is that the fact that there are many Indonesian people that lack consume of fruit and vegetable, which lead to vitamin and mineral deficiency. But the awareness of the people oftentimes trigger to some disease as a result of prolonged deficiency. Therefore, we need some prevention method for the deficiency, like application to make early detection of vitamin and mineral deficiency. As previous works in detecting mineral and vitamin deficiency shown that the method used is still focused in the static environment using traditional rule-based system and uncertainty methods that still not considered the big amount of data with verifying complexity that arise from the number of symptoms and the relationship between the symptoms. In this, our problem formulation and solution. From the various facts mentioned, we propose that tolerate the dynamic environment such as the complexity relationship between symptoms and the big number of the symptoms. Neural network is one of the methods that can tackle the dynamic environment. Learning algorithm is one of the important components in the neural networks that determine the accuracy of the result. From many learnings of the neural networks, we use LFQ or linear factor quantization to proven to give accurate result in our case. Reflex on the result, we try to use LFQ as a learning algorithm to find the early detection of vitamin and mineral deficiency. Considering the some version of LFQ, we also try each of the version and compare the result to which version is the best for our case, like LFQ first version, second version, and LFQ 3.0 version. And this is the data set that we use in our experiment. Due to our case is a vitamin and mineral deficiency, we use physical symptoms as the input of our neural network's architecture. There are 107 physical symptoms such as dizzy eyes and panting breath. And our architecture has 17 output nodes that reflect the 17 kinds of vitamin and mineral deficiency. Our data set contains 100 instances that will be divided into training and testing data with several combination. Before we put the data into the architecture, we do the data transformation to transform the physical symptoms into binary number, like 1 and 0. As we can see in the table, where the binary number 1 mean yes and binary number 0 mean no. And this is our neural network architecture. We can see here that there are 107 input nodes and 70 output nodes. Do we use LVQ? We have 20 competitive layers between input and output layer. The competitive layer save the codebook factor, that's a special algorithm for the LVQ that represent of its class in the dataset. The value of the codebook factor is dynamically changed during the training process. LVQ using Euclidean distance to measure the distance between input and codebook factor as shown at in the red circle in our picture. We also set 3 experiment scenario to get the best parameter values. The experiment conducted using trial and error approach. There are 5 parameters like epsilon, learning rate, codebook factor, epoch, and window that need to be trained to get the best value. In first scenario, we train 3 of the parameters like epsilon, learning rate, and window. In the second scenario, we train codebook factor, and the last scenario, we train the epoch. The result of the experiment show that the optimal parameter setting are 0.2 for the epsilon, 0.4 for the learning rate, 20 for the codebook factor, 2,400 for the epoch, and 0.3 for the window. As we can see all the values in our left side table, this one. Yeah. We also divide the data set into some ratio or combination of data training and data testing, like 80-20, 80-18. And we found that the ratio that give the best accuracy is 84 ratio for the data training, 84, and the testing is 16. This accuracy we can achieve 85.71% with the ratio of this data training and data testing. We also compare some version of linear factor quantization using the same value of parameter and ratio of the data training and data testing. From the experiment, we can see LVQ version 3 can give the best accuracy, that is 85.71% compared with the LVQ version 1 and version 2.1. Besides make comparison with some version of LVQ, we also make comparison with different learning algorithm. We make comparison with propagation network, like we know as a BPN. Yeah, the result show that LVQ can give better accuracy for our case compared with BPN or backpropagation neural network. As our conclusion, we can conclude that LVQ is proven can be used for detection of vitamin and mineral deficiency. through several experiments conducted by trial and error approach, we also can get the optimal parameter value. The best version of FAQ of our case is FAQ version 3. And when we compared with other learning algorithm like a back propagation network, FAQ also show better accuracy value when detecting vitamin and mineral deficiency. For the future works, we can extend our experiment by using more data for the training and testing, and we can get the data from the patient, and we also can try to use the other evaluation method such as a K-hold validation and using deep learning to make detection of our case should be interesting and need to be observed deeply. That's all for our presentation. Thanks for listening. I hope we already done is acceptable and understandable. Thank you.
Thank you, Pak Iwan. So from the audience, is there any questions? Okay, it's not yet. So you could write the questions to the chat chat room, yeah. So for the audience, you could write a question for the chat room. So we still have around 9 minutes. So maybe I could start to ask to the Pak Iwan. So in the beginning, how is the motivation to do this research, Pak? Is there any because the deficiency of the vitamin and mineral in the case study, it's a lot or it's difficult to detect, or how is it, Pak?
Yeah, the first motivation is in our campus has a faculty of medicine. According to our friends from the doctor, that they very difficult to find the deficiency of the vitamin and mineral from the case like symptoms or which one is the vitamin or mineral deficiency. So based on this motivation, we like to try our algorithm. We are from industrial engineering and computer science. We want to use our algorithm to help the doctor or the health technician to solve their problem.
All right. So thank you. There is another question, Pak Iwan. Could you explain the misclassified patterns? Are the classes balanced or imbalanced?
Yeah. About this question, Mr. Anto, yeah. The data, it means according to my opinion, our data is a balanced class. Yeah. Has a similar number of patterns.
And about the misclassified pattern, Pak?
Yeah, the misclassified. We need to clarify about that. Yeah, the misclassified patterns. Okay, maybe I will asking to our Bu Nina. Yeah, to asking about the data. Yeah, the patterns.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Yes, thank you, Pak Iwan.
Okay.
So basically all the data comes from your college in the faculty kedokteran, ya Pak?
Yeah, we get the data from the doctor and then from the like a respondent, yeah, respondent from the medical of faculty, yeah. And then we collect the data and then we try to to transform it to binary number. Yeah, the data training is maybe it's good for if we can find, we can get from the patient. Yeah, maybe in our next research, we want to get the data from the patients.
Okay, so the current data still not from the patient yet.
In our research, this research is we combine. We combine with the information from the doctor and then the patient. We combine it because to find the respondents is really difficult. And then we combine first.
All right. But
we try the algorithm with the data is satisfied for the performance. Oh,
right.
Yeah.
Yes. So,
oh, yeah. Bu Nina, can you explain about the misclassified patterns? Bu Nina in here. Bu Nina,
okay,
is,
Bu Nina
from
is,
the,
is here. Yeah.
Yeah, from the computer science.
Bu Nina?
Bu Nina, could you explain about the misclassified patterns or balance class?
Okay, already unmute, yeah. Okay, good day, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for the opportunity. Before I answer the question, maybe I need to make some clarification about the meaning of misclassified pattern. Is the meaning that the wrong decision from the system or what? I mean
The wrong decisions of the systems.
Oh, so the misclassified pattern is the meaning the wrong decision from the system, right?
Yes, yes.
Okay, in here, the misclassified pattern can be we not observe deeply about the misclassified pattern as the Mr. Iwan said already. So I think in our analysis, the misclassified pattern could be happen because the training data itself is too little. I mean, we process it with neural network, and one of the challenges in neural network is it needs some bigger data or many instance in the data set itself to get a better model. But in our case, we have some limitation in here. We don't have enough data. We have just 100 about primary data. So I mean, the misclassified pattern can be happen because we make the training process using a small number of training data. And that is our limitation. And the future work, we want to try to train the data using a bigger data set. But I mean, it's not easy to collect a primary data because we using really primary. We using questionnaire and survey and interview with the patient and the doctor to get the data. So in here, I can conclude that the misclassifying pattern can be in our experiment happen because we process it using a small number of training data. And what happened because it's difficult to get the primary data in a large number. So yeah, I think that is our analysis about your question about the misclassified pattern or the misclassified result of our system. It happened because the training data is too small.
Yeah, thank you. But perhaps this just suggestions if you want to write the journal for your research. Perhaps it is important for you to analyze the error, the misclassified pattern, so the reader will understand the limitations and the goodness of your method. Just suggestion. Thank you.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Mr. Anto, for your suggestion. Yes, we will improve our paper and our presentation with explain about the limitation in our observation and experiment. Thank you, Mr. Anto.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Thank you, Pak Iwan, Bu Nina, and also Pak Anto. Yeah, of course we could improve our papers and then extend it, and then we could also send to the other journal. Yeah, for the complete papers or complete research. All right. So since time is up, thank you, Pak Iwan, for your time and your presentation and research.